بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال الإمام شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب التميمي رحمه الله تعالى في كتابه الأصول الثلاثة. So the Imam شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب التميمي, he mentions, may Allah have mercy upon him, in his tremendous book, Al-Usul Al-Thalatha, the three principles, the three principles. قال وأنواع العبادة التي أمر الله بها. So he says, and the types of worship which Allah Ta'ala has commanded with, مثل الإسلام, like Al-Islam, والإيمان, and like belief, والإحسان, and like Al-Ihsan, to worship Allah as if you see Him. And although you do not see Him, you know that Allah sees you. وَمِنْهُ الدُّعَى, and from these various forms of worship is dua. وَالْخَوْفُ وَالرَّجَاءُ وَالتَّوَكُّلُ وَالرَّغْبَةُ وَالرَّهْبَةُ وَالْخُشُوعُ وَالْخَشْيَةُ وَالْإِنَابَةُ وَالْإِسْتِعَانَةُ وَالْإِسْتِعَاذَةُ وَالْإِسْتِغَاثَةُ وَالذَّبْحُ وَالنَّذْرُ وَغَيْرُ ذَلِكَ من العبادة التي أمر الله بها كلها لله. He says, from these forms of worship is dua, supplication, and fear, and having hope with Allah, and a tawakkul, having dependence and trust upon Allah. والرغبة والرهبة, and desire and dread or awe, and الخشوع, and the fear of Allah that is built upon knowledge, or rather al-khushu', humility and humbleness, wal-khashya, which is the fear of Allah that is built upon knowledge, wal-inabatu, and repentance, wal-isti'anatu, and seeking aid and assistance from Allah, wal-isti'adatu, and seeking refuge and protection with Allah, wal-istighathatu, and seeking rain or the lights, وَالذَّبْحُ, and slaughtering and sacrificing, وَالنَّذَرُ, and oaths and trusts or vows, وَغَيْرُ ذَلِكَ, and other than that, مِنَ الْعِبَادَةِ الَّتِي أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهَا, from the forms of worship that Allah Ta'ala has commanded with, كُلُّهَا لِلَّهِ, all of these types of worship belong exclusively for Allah. وَالدَّلِيلُ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى, and the proof to this is his statement, the mighty and the majestic, where he says, وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا, Surah Al-Jinn, where Allah Ta'ala says, and that is that the masajid, all of the masajid belong to Allah. So do not invoke, supplicate, worship, call upon other than Allah, anyone. Surah Al-Jinn. نستفيد من هذه الآية الفائدة الأولى, benefit number one from the verse. Benefit number one from this verse. أن المساجد كلها لله سبحانه وتعالى. Benefit number one, that the masajid, the houses of Allah, they belong to Allah. They belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَا يَمْلِكُ الْمَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. So no one owns the houses of Allah. No one possesses the houses of Allah. The houses of Allah, the masajid of Allah, do not belong to any one particular person. لَا بَلْ هِيَ لِلَّهِ تَعَالَى, هِيَ لِلَّهِ تَعَالَى, but rather, the houses of Allah belong to Allah exclusively and solely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. والفائدة الثانية, benefit number two, أن الدعاء لغير الله والعبادة لغير الله حرام والشرك. حرام والشرك. Benefit number two is that supplicating to other than Allah, invoking other than Allah, worshipping other than Allah is haram and it is shirk. It's haram and It is shirk. والفائدة الثالثة, benefit number three, أهمية تعليم اللغة العربية. اللغة العربية. Benefit number three, the virtues and the importance of learning and studying the Arabic language. لأن الله تعالى ختم هذه الآية بالاسم, باسم يا إخوان النكرة. Because Allah Ta'ala in this verse, He concludes this verse. He stops this verse with the nakira. مع الله أحدا أحدا وهذا الاسم هو نكر. So this noun here, أحدا, it is نكرة. It is نكرة. و it is indefinite. فالكلمة التي تكون نكرة تفيد العموم. So the word that is indefinite, it shows the generality. فيقول تعالى فلا تدع مع الله أحدا أحدا. So Allah says, do not worship, do not invoke along with Allah أحدا, anyone or anything. وهذه الكلمة يفيد العموم. So this word here, or تفيد العموم, it shows the generality. In any way that you can call upon other than Allah, in any form that you can worship other than Allah, فهو لا يجوز, then it's not allowed. وهو حرام, and it's prohibited. وهو الشرك, and it is polytheism. فنهاية هذه الآية, ماذا تحث العبد العجمية على تعليم العربية, تعليم العربية. So the ending of this verse, the fact that Allah ends the verse with the indefinite noun, shows that this is general. So it teaches the non-Arab, the foreigner, the virtues of learning and studying something from the Arabic language, something from the Arabic language. قال بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. So the Imam continues. قال فمن صرف منها شيئا لغير الله. So he says, so anyone, whomsoever, anyone who directs any form, anything from these affairs to other than Allah, فهو مشرك كافر. Then he is one who is a polytheist, and he has disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالدَّلِيلُ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى. And the proof to this is the statement of Allah, the Mighty and the Majestic. وَمَنْ يَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرَ لَا بُرْهَانَ لَهُ بِهِ فَإِنَّمَا حِسَابُهُ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الْكَافِرُونَ. الآية سورة المؤمنون. As Allah Ta'ala, He says, Allah Ta'ala, He says, and anyone who calls upon, invokes, along with Allah, ilahan akhar, another deity, another God, another deity, la burhana lahu bih, then he has no authority, he has no proof to do so. Fa innama hisabuhu inda rabbih, and verily his account is with his Lord. إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الْكَافِرُونَ. Verily, the disbelieving people, they are not successful. The disbelieving people, they are not successful. فَبَيَّنَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى فِي هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ أَنَّ مَنْ يَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرَ لَا دَلِيلَ لَهُ بِأَنْ يَدْعُوَ مَعَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى غَيْرَ اللَّهِ. مَعَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى غَيْرَ اللَّهِ. So in this ayah, Allah clarifies for the Muslim that anyone who calls upon other than Allah, he calls upon, he supplicates to, he worships other than Allah, then he has no proof to do so. He has no authority to do so. فَلَذِي يَعْبُدُ عِيسَى بْنَ مَرْيَمَ لَا دَلِيلَ لَهُ. So the one who worships Isa ibn Maryam, he has no right to worship him. وَالَذِي يَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى غَيْرَ اللَّهِ لَا دَلِيلَ لَهُ. So the one who supplicates and makes dua to other than Allah, in reality, he has no proof to do so. He has no proof to do so. ونستفيد من هذه الآية أهمية الأخذ بالدليل بالبرهان. And we benefit from this verse also. The importance of the proofs in evidences in al-Islam. Al-Islam yubna al-dalil, yubna al-burhan. Islam is built upon proofs and evidences. Uktubu hadhi akhwan, write this down. Al-Islam la yubna al-ara, bal yubna al-dalil. Islam is not built upon opinions, never. But rather, al-Islam is built upon proofs. فيقول تعالى لا برهان لا برهان له به. So Allah Ta'ala says he has no proof, he has no authority to do so. He has no authority to do so. ونستفيد من هذه الآية حال الكافرين أن الكفار لا يفلحون لا يفلحون. And we also benefit in this verse the condition or the status of the disbelievers. فَالَذِي جَاءَهُ الْإِسْلَامُ ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّى عَنْهُ وَجَاءَهُ الْإِسْلَامُ صِدِقًا ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّى عَنْهُ وَيَمُوتُ عَلَى غَيْرِ الْإِسْلَامِ لَا يُفْلِحُ أَبَدًا لَا يُفْلِحُ أَبَدًا. So any individual that a true representation of Islam or Islam reaches him truly, truthfully, وَتَوَلَّى عَنْهُ, but he turns away, she turns away from al-Islam, ثُمَّ تَمُوتُ عَلَى غَيْرِ الْإِسْلَامِ, and then this woman, this young lady, dies upon other than Islam, لَا تُفْلِحُ, she is never going to be successful. وَيَقُولُ تَعَالَى إِنُّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الْكَافِرُونَ. As Allah Ta'ala says, verily, the disbelievers, they are not successful. They will not be successful. فالكافر الذي يموت على غير الإسلام يموت كافرا بالله سبحانه وتعالى ويكون في نار جهنم ويكون في نار جهنم ونعوذ بالله. So the disbeliever, the one who dies upon other than al-Islam, in the hereafter, he's going to be in the hellfire. فأي شخص سمع عن محمد والذي سمع منه حق فهو سمع عن محمد عليه عن محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام أو يرى محمدا عليه الصلاة والسلام ثم تولى عنه ويموت على غير الإسلام يكون في نار جهنم يكون في نار جهنم. So the one who hears about Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام and what he heard about Muhammad is true, it wasn't a lie, wasn't fabricated, or he saw Muhammad, or he met Muhammad, alayhi salatu wasalam, but he turned away from al-Islam, and dies upon other than al-Islam, this individual in the hereafter, wana'udhu billah, is going to be in the hellfire. Qala Shaykh al-Islam, so Shaykh al-Islam, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhabi continues, قال وفي الحديث الدعاء مخ العبادة. And he says, and in the hadith, supplication or dua is the core or the essence of worship. فائدة يا اخوان, a benefit. هذا الحديث ولو ذكره شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله تعالى ها هنا في أصول الثلاثة ولكن الحديث ضعيف الحديث ضعيف. Benefit يا إخوان, you brothers and sisters who are studying hadith, this hadith here, that dua is the core of worship. Dua مخ العبادة is the essence, the core of worship. Although Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, may Allah have mercy upon him, mentions this hadith, and other than him from the people of knowledge mentioned this hadith, in reality this hadith is weak. In reality this hadith is weak. هو حديث أنس. It is the hadith of Anas أخرجه الترمذي رحمه الله. And it's collected by Imam Abu Isa al-Tirmidhi in his Sunan. ولكنه ضعيف. But it is weak. في سنده ابن هيعة. Ibn Hay'a. In the chain is a man by the name of Ibn Luhay'a. وهو ضعيف. And he is weak. And he is weak. قال شيخ الإسلام والدليل قوله تعالى. So Shaykh al-Islam continues. He says, and the proof is the statement of Allah, the Mighty and the Majestic. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ صُرُتُ غَافِرٍ. As Allah Ta'ala, He says, and your Lord says, supplicate to me, invoke me, أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ, and I, meaning Allah, I will answer you. Verily those who are too arrogant and too prideful to supplicate or to worship me, to make their worship for me and me alone, verily they are going to enter into the blazing fire of hell. Wa na'udhu billah. Suratu Ghafir. Suratu Ghafir. Qala Sheikh Abdul Aziz ibn Baz rahimahullah. So Sheikh Abdul Aziz ibn Baz, he continues. قال العبادة أنواع. He says worship is of various categories and various types. قال فمنها الإسلام بأركانه. He says, and from these types of worship is Islam with its pillars. فكل ما أمر الله به من أعمال الإسلام عبادة. So then Sheikh ibn Baz brings a tremendous point. Rahimahullah. He says, so everything that Allah commands with from the actions of Islam is worship. Allahu Akbar. كُلَّ مَا يَعْمُرُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى بِهِ مِنْ أَعْمَالِ الْإِسْلَامِ يُسَمَّى عِبَادَةً يُسَمَّى عِبَادَةً. Everything that Allah commands with from the actions of Al-Islam is worship. قال شيخ ابن باز من صلاة. He says, from prayer, وصوم and fasting, وغير ذلك, and other than that. وهكذا الإيمان بأعمال الباطنة. And likewise, from the affairs of belief, and those inward actions of belief. كالإيمان بالله, like having belief in Allah. وملائكته, and His angels. وكتبه, and His books. ورسله, and His messengers. واليوم الآخرة, and having belief in the last day. والإيمان بالقدر خيره وشره, and having belief in the divine decree of Allah, it's good and it's bad. وكذلك الخوف, likewise الخوف, having the fear. والمحبة, and love. والرجاء, and hope. إلى غير ذلك, to other than that, from the forms of worship. فَكُلَّ مَا يَتَعَلَّقُ بِالْقُلُوبِ دَاخِلٌ فِي الْعِبَادَةِ. So everything that is connected from the actions of the heart is called worship. Allahu Akbar. وَهَكَذَا الْإِحْسَانُ. Likewise, what is called al-ihsan. أَنْ تَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ. That the person worships Allah as if He sees Allah. نستفيد من هنا يا إخوان معنى الإحسان عند أهل السنة والجماعة وليس عند الصوفية. A benefit. With regards to إحسان, what does إحسان mean? Some people, they say spirituality. What does إحسان mean? From the people of أهل السنة, and what does it mean from الصوفية? الإحسان عند أهل السنة وجماعة يا إخوان أن يعبد الله تعالى أو أن يعبد الله تعالى كأنه يراه. So to the people of أهل السنة وجماعة, may Allah make us and you from amongst them, إحسان to them is that the person, he's worshiping Allah as if he sees him. أي يعبد العبادة أو يعبد ربه سبحانه وتعالى كأنه ضمن هذه العبادة يرى ربه. هو لا يرى ربه ولكن من ظاهر عبادته لله تعالى كأنه ينظر إلى ربه. So the person, he does not see Allah, but from how perfect and how well his worship is, it seems that he's worshiping Allah as if he sees Allah. كما قال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام, as the Prophet of Allah said, من حديث عمر عند الإمام مسلم ومن حديث أبي هريرة عند الإمام البخاري ومسلم, from the hadith of Umar that is collected by Imam Muslim, and from the narration of Abu Huraira that is collected by Bukhari and Muslim. فالإحسان عند الصوفية, in إحسان to the people of الصوفية, هو درجة إذا يبلغه العبد ليس عليه العبادة, هو منزلة فوق منزلة الأنبياء والمرسلين, وإذا لا عبد يبلغه ليس عليه العبادة ونعوذ بالله. So to the Sufiya, Ihsan is a station that is above the station of the Prophets and Messengers ونعوذ بالله. And if the servant reaches this station, he no longer has to worship Allah. وهذا لا يصح. And that's not correct يا إخوان. ولكن هذا معنى الإحسان عندهم عند هؤلاء. This is not correct, but this is what those individuals perceive, that Ihsan is a station, a level, a platform, if you will, that is above the status of the prophets and messengers. وإذا يبلغه العبد ليس عليه العبادة, and if the servant reaches this level, he no longer has to worship Allah. وهذا كفر. But to believe that is disbelief. To believe that is disbelief. فنفس الكلمة ولكن معنى هذه الكلمة مختلف عند هؤلاء وعند أهل السنة وجماعة. أهل السنة وجماعة. So you have the same word, إحسان. But you see how different people, different groups differ in the meaning of the word. إحسان to a Sufiya has one meaning. And إحسان to the people of أهل السنة والجماعة has another meaning. قال شيخ ابن باز رحمه الله بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. شيخ ابن باز continues. قال وهكذا الإحسان. He says, and similarly is الإحسان أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. Whereas you worship Allah as though you see Him. وهذا أيضا من العبادة. He says, and this is also from worship. بل هو أعلى الأنواع العبادة وأعظمها. He says, but rather it is from the highest, the most elevated forms of worship, and it is the greatest form of worship. قال شيخ ابن باز فالواجب على كل مكلف إخلاص العبادة لله وحده. So he says, رحمه الله, so what is obligatory upon every entrusted individual from mankind and from the jinn is to be sincere, to make their worship sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. فَلَا يَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ. So he does not call upon, along with Allah, any of the prophets and messengers. وَلَا الْأَوْلِيَاءَ, nor any of the righteous. وَلَا الْأَصْنَامَ, nor any of the idols. وَلَا الْأَشْجَارَ, nor any of the trees. وَلَا الْأَشْجَارَ, nor any of the trees. وَلَا الْأَحْجَارَ, nor any of the rocks or stones. وَلَا النُّجُومَ, nor any of the stars. لِأَنَّ الْعِبَادَةَ حَقٌ لِلَّهِ وَحْدًا. Because worship is from the rights that are exclusive for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. قال تعالى, as Allah Ta'ala he mentions, وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. Surah Al-Jinn, as Allah says, and the masajid, they belong to Allah. So do not invoke along with Allah anything or anyone. Surah Al-Jinn. وقال الله تعالى ولا تدع من دون الله ما لا ينفعك ولا يضرك فإن فعلت فإنك إذا من الظالمين. سورة يونس. As Allah Ta'ala says, and do not invoke, do not supplicate others than Allah, that which would cannot bring you any benefit, وَلَا يَضُرُّكَ, nor bring you any harm. And if you do this, meaning if you supplicate other than Allah, then verily you are from the oppressors. You are from the oppressors. Surah Yunus. وَيَقُولُ تَعَالَى, and Allah also mentions, وَمَنْ يَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرَ لَا بُرْهَانَ لَهُ بِهِ فَإِنَّمَا حِسَابُهُ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الْكَافِرُونَ. Surah Mu'minun. As Allah Ta'ala says, and whoever invokes, whoever supplicates, whoever makes dua along with Allah to another God, another deity, لَا بُرْهَانَ لَهُ بِهِ, then he has no proof, no authority, no right to do so. And verily his account is with his Lord. And surely the disbelievers will never prosper, will never be successful. Allahu Akbar, ikhwan. طيب فنكتفي بهذا. We'll stop here, ikhwan. هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد. وجزاكم الله خيرا وسبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.